When people take time to learn and to create, they're able to see the value in one another and to know that it's not just an individual that's creating something. It's a person that walked around and they rubbed shoulders with others and they got ideas from others and they added those ideas to their ideas and formed new concepts. I'm Eileen Kulseth from Crosslake, Minnesota. Today we're going to create an oval casserole that has two parts to it that are interesting. One is wheel thrown and one is hand built. So to combine the two pieces together is the trick. And I will show you all the details of how to put that together in a functioning 2-quart casserole that has style with elements and principles of design. Okay, when you start out with clay and you want your pieces to be predictable so you can make them again, you want to weigh them. The piece that I'm going to make is an oval casserole. It's part hand-built, part wheel-thrown. And this part is the rim that will be wheel-thrown, and it is 4 pounds. Okay, what I'm doing right now is wedging the clay. And the purpose of this is really important, that you are getting the molecules compressed. And the more you prepare your clay, the less chance of things cracking in the firing process in the kiln. I go one direction and then I compress it into an oval. And then I turn it, face it towards me, and do it again. It's similar to kneading bread dough, just heavier, thicker. Now the test of it is to cut it. Cut it with a wire tool and look to see, are there any air bubbles? No. So you put it back together like a puzzle piece and compress it some more. And you can probably do this for 10 minutes. If it's a really big piece, you want to keep wedging it because you don't want it to crack. Now what I'm doing is beginning to form it into a ball so I can throw it on the wheel. Might as well let gravity help you on that part. The more symmetrical you prepare your piece, the easier it is to center it on the wheel. And it's ready. Okay, now it's time to throw it on the wheel. Okay. All right, first thing that we're going to do is called throwing. Okay, I'm getting this prepared to center. One thing I've found that's key is the more accurate you can get it as far as being symmetrical in the center of your wheel, the easier it goes. I'm just doing that to connect it. All right. As a potter, you don't want to have friction, and that's why you're going to see me continually put water on the clay. Okay, first up, I'm just going to connect it to the wheel head by pushing down. And now it's connected, so now I'm going to start centering it. If you can see my hands are moving around, because the clay is moving it. As a potter, you need to be able to tell the clay what it's going to do. And so you need to push as hard as you can. Keep your hands as steady and strong and still. And then you start to feel the clay adjusting to you, rather than the clay telling you what it's going to do. I'm just feeling it to sense if the clay is moving anywhere or if it feels like it's uneven. I have friction. And I'm just smoothing it and making it ready to go to the next step. Okay, now it's centered. Now what I need to do, because I'm going to make a large oval casserole, I need to spread this clay out. And so I will begin to do that by just pushing it out before I shape it into a ring. Out as far as, like, it's gonna get too thin if I go any farther. So now it's time to put a hole in the center. And the thing that's unusual about this step is that usually you don't want to go to the bottom. You don't want a hole in the bottom of your pot. But I do. Okay, now I need to bring the ring out. So I'm gonna be pushing very hard to the right. I'm trying to keep my ring symmetrical. Side out from time to time. And now I need to flatten it again to gradually, I need to keep it connected to the bat that's on this wheel. And I need it larger than this. The size of the hole in the center. You just don't want the clay to be in a puddle of water because it weakens the clay. Now I'm getting ready to get it prepared into a shape of a ring to pull the wall up. I have it stretched out as far as I want it. Just starting to define the wall with my left hand. And I'm going to do one more clean on the inside. And now it's time to pull the wall up. I've been throwing for over 40 years. And what I've learned that makes it successful is the position of your hands. That your fingers need to be right across from each other and apply the same amount of pressure on the inside as the outside. Okay? Everything now will be a very slow, controlled pressure. Sliding up. My first goal is just to get the wall even in thickness. And another thing that makes this design visually pleasing is that the rim will be wider and have some bulk to it. It makes it look strong. It's flaring out a little bit more than I want, so I'm going to try. I'm going got to get it really slippery to bring the top of the wall back in. So I'm applying pressure in four different points across from each other. And now the wall's more vertical. Another thing I've learned through the years is that edges, rims of pottery need to not be sharp. So you want to dull the edges, get them a little bit rounded, and then there's less chipping that happens. Then you use a chamois and you lay it on there lightly and put pressure on it like a feather touch and lift it off slowly. The next step is to get it off the wheel. So I make a groove on the inside at the very base of it, and a groove on the outside. And when I do that, sometimes I get clay that bunches up. I want to clean up the edge that formed from making that groove. And sometimes I have to go back and make the groove again. Now I'm going to take this wire, and actually it would be wise if I just put water in front of it so it will slide. Hold on to it tight, and I'm going to seesaw it through, there we go, and bring it straight across and out, and now it's separated from the wheel. This is a two-day process, okay? Since this is a two-day process, I came over here yesterday and I made another rim. It needed time to dry so it would be leather hard. And this is the condition it's in right now. So I can move it, shape it. Okay. Now I'm going to recut it. You do this carefully. So it did separate, which is great. All right, the cool thing about this is that you just push on opposite sides and it will form a graceful oval. Now I'm going to create a base for it, which I'll create on my slab roller. Okay. Since the wall is a certain thickness and it's less than a half an inch, so on my slab roller I have different measurements, and right now I have it set at 3/8. And then you flip it back, so I stretched it out widthwise. And then you just grab it and pull it. And it gives you an even consistency. Okay, now I need to get this off. Peel it back. Set it on here. This is ready. Take my two parts together. And I'll bring them over to the table. All right. First step is to draw a line around the perimeter of my casserole to know what to cut away. Okay, my perimeter is drawn, and now I can cut it away. peel the excess away or to the side. Flip it over. This is the best time to sign your piece. Okay, now it's ready to attach to the ring. When you put pieces of clay together, you want them to make sure that they're not going to pull apart. And so you use a technique that's called scoring. And it's basically drawing X's with a stylus in the clay on both surfaces where it will be attached. Try to draw your scoring marks within the area that will be covered. And then the same way, I have to do it on the back side. So then you use water for your glue. I just want to make sure it feels kind of like slip, which is just wet clay. Okay, you flip it over. Connect it to your perimeter base by just very carefully putting pressure and moving it back and forth. I can tell if it's going to be connected. All right, this is good. Now it's connected, but it doesn't look very good. So we have to blend it in. And I just use wooden tools. Okay, so it's connected, but I just have to keep smoothing it. All right, then the outside, I'm going to use a tool and just bring the clay up and attach it to the side. So it's like a rough attachment first, and then you go back and you smooth it. And now I am going to smooth with just continual movements where I'm trying to be kind of fluid in my movement so it doesn't look chopped. Just use your fingertip to smooth it. And you usually work pretty dry, so you're not really adding water to it. If you add water to it, it will make it soggy. And the other thing is these little pieces, if you move them away from the surface you're working on, then they don't attach themselves to the piece that you're working on. Okay, I'm going to very carefully lift this up. Probably stand up. Flip it. Okay. By doing that, I'll just have an opportunity to finish the bottom.
Please hold.
by rubbing my fingertip across the rough edges. Helps to go one direction instead of going back and forth. Now I need to flip it over and put handles on it. Now it's time to make the handle. I need two handles, so I've made one, but now I need to make another one. It's about 3/8. And I'll use my first handle as my template. Just a general template, not an accurate one. Gives it a thicker edge. And I want to have a smooth, graceful look to it, so I don't want any angles. I want it to be more organic looking. And I will form it to get the curl to my tool. Then I need to measure it. Okay. And then where I cut it, I just need to smooth it. All right, do they match? They don't match exactly, you can squish it into place. Okay, now it's time to attach it. Symmetry is what I want, so I want them to be on opposite sides. Okay, so I'm going to take a ruler, put it in the center, eye it up to see that it's in the middle. Just set my handle in the middle, handle in the center, and I made marks with my fingernail, and now I know where to attach it. So just rotate it. When I attach clay to clay, I want to use scoring marks. So I'll use those little X's again, wherever I'm going to connect it. On both pieces. And I use water as my glue. Now we're going to connect it where I put the glue. And you just push. And that handle's on. Next one, we're so close to being done. Now I can just eye it up. All right, again, I'm gonna make little marks where the edge should be with my fingernail. Do the scoring marks on both pieces. And water for glue. Attach the scored marks. Apply pressure. I'm just smoothing it. And I don't see any marks this time. Okay, this. This is just touch up time. Now it's critique time. I'm gonna match my drawing, see if I matched what I was intending to do. And the principles and the elements were balance. The balance is in that the thickness of the bottom is 3/8, the wall is 3/8, the handles are 3/8 of an inch. Proportions, I had to pay attention to see if my handles, are they too big for the piece or are they balanced? I think they're proportionately the right size. And unity, does the whole thing have a unity to it in the sense that it's all organic, it's not angular, it's smooth, it's natural, it's flowing, it's oval, it's curved. And so I mimicked the curve, the oval, in the handles, in the curve of the handles. And shape, line, space, is it space-wise, is it utilitarian? I was going for a 2-quart casserole, and I'm sure this will hold 2 quarts. So I guess I would say I accomplished what I was aiming for.